You're not the only one that finds data science interviews hard. That was me a few years ago until I learned a few things to get through it. Today, I'll tell you everything you need to know to crack the data science interview. So you've already applied for a data science position and you've been invited to interview. In summary, there are three stages to a data science interview process. The first is the screening interview. The second is the technical interview. And the third stage is the on-site interview or in-person interviews. Let's talk about the screening interview. This stage is the easiest part of the entire interview process. This is simply a phone chat with either the recruiter or a data scientist from the company you're applying to. The goal of this screening is to figure out whether you're the right person to be applying for this type of a job and get a general sense as to your experience based on what you say in your resume. A basic check as to whether or not you're the person you say you are on your resume. It's a shallow culture type fit, and don't be surprised if they're throw in some basic machine learning questions in there, such as what is a validation set or what is regularization. So be sure to brush up on your basics before you do a screening interview. So once you get past the screening interview, you'll most likely be invited to do a technical test or a technical interview. As being a data scientist is a fairly technical role, the companies want to know that you have a good foundation in coding and data science. This stage can vary significantly in difficulty based on whether you're applying for a junior, mid-level, or senior roles. And it's usually done in two ways. The first is an online data science quiz, and the second is a take-home data science assignment. Let's talk about the first one. The online data science quiz will usually be a timed, multiple choice style questions, or it can be an online console test, which requires you to write some code. Almost all of these tests will require you to answer questions about your understanding of SQL, Python, statistics, and data science. And these tests will be administered in some sort of an online platform, such as HackerRank, TestGorilla, TestDome, or Aluba. It'll be a mix of theoretical and practical questions. So let's go through some examples across all of those four categories I mentioned. So an example of an SQL test could be the following. Given the following data definition, write an SQL query to find all the students who had a test score greater than 80 and whose first name is not John. Feel free to pause the video to take a stab at it. The solution is the following. Again, the difficulty of the SQL related question will vary based on the level you apply for. Examples of Python questions could be, what is a lambda in Python? Or how do you filter based on a particular column value in a data frame? As for questions related to statistics, an example could be, give me examples of data that are not normally distributed. And in this case, the answer would be categorical data like the education level of a person or data that adheres to exponential distributions, like the amount of time in months that a car battery lasts. Finally, examples of data science questions could include, what is a random forest, or how does it differ to logistic regression? And there's a whole variety of questions like that that I found online that helped me greatly to prepare for data science interviews. And I'll be sure to leave them in the description below. Alternatively, instead of an online data quiz, you might actually have this technical interview with a data scientist at the company. But the types of questions they ask will be very similar. Let's move on to the second type of technical test they might give you, which is the take-home data science assignment. From my experience, this is usually a Kaggle style questions that requires you to do the working and present it in a Jupyter style notebook. And you usually have around 2 to 3 days to complete something like this, or you might actually get this assignment online and you might have a couple of hours to do it. An example of this could be a Kaggle challenge, which requires you to predict sale prices of houses. And they might give you a data set of 100,000 houses with 80 of 90 features. And the task will be to create a model that can best predict the sale price of a house. This test is really to show off your technical skills as well as your communication skills. So really the way you approach this type of problem is, firstly, you would engage in a exploratory data analysis. And this is really when you interrogate the data set. Some of the analysis that you might do in a step like this is to figure out the correlations between the features in the data set and visualizing any trends that you might find. For example, in the case of our house price challenge, you might want to take a look at whether the average number of bedrooms varies based on the neighborhood the house is in, or try to figure out how the sale price varies based on the area of the garage. After your analysis, you will conduct a data cleaning exercise and doing any necessary feature engineering that you might need to do, after which you'll try try out a couple of algorithms that get the job done. And this process will be something that's iterative, and always make sure to explain your reasoning behind a choice of model and your method of evaluating it, or moving on from it to another model. The whole point of this task is to take your interviewer through a data science journey, because really you're building a story around solving this problem. So keep that in mind when you go through this stage. And something useful that I've found is to really hunt down some of these Kaggle challenges and look at the solutions that got the most number of votes, because they usually tend to be the ones that have been great at communicating the steps that they've taken, and they've also been able to present a fairly reasonable approach to solving the problem. And I've really found it very interesting to learn from the best on those websites, so I couldn't recommend it highly enough. And in some cases, you might actually get a mix of the online data quiz and also a take-home exam. I would really encourage you to prepare for all possibilities, as you really don't know which company might use what method. If you're enjoying the video so far, consider subscribing. I make weekly videos about demystifying the land of data science. Now let's talk about on-site interviews. So you've passed your technical interviews and you'll be invited to interview with a data scientist or a lead data scientist at the company. Before COVID, this would have been in person, but these days it's quite normal to expect Zoom interviews. In these interviews, there'll be a mix of experience questions, scenario-based questions, and culture fit behavioral style questions. By this stage, they've generally got a fairly good sense as to your technical abilities. The first thing they'll want to know is about your work experience. So this is where they might ask you to describe a particular data science problem that you've solved at a previous company or some personal data science project that you've undertaken. In this step, they're really looking to see that you can describe things in a simple and understandable manner without getting into the weeds. Because a large part of the role of a data scientist is liaising with different stakeholders. So the next type of questions they'll ask is scenario-based questions. They'll want to assess how your problem-solving abilities are regarding specific data science problems in the company that you're interviewing for. Suppose you're interviewing for a social media company with an online platform, and they've recently released a new feature which allows users to upload a 10-second GIF. And they want you to figure out whether this feature has increased user engagement on the platform. Questions like this really require you to fully immerse yourself into the problem space and think practically about an A-B style of experiment. Your answer should be more of a discussion with your interviewer rather than a rigid answer. Again, they want to evaluate your thought process, and don't be afraid to ask clarifying questions. The interviewers want you to succeed. Some of these scenario-based questions might also involve you picking a specific type of model for a type of problem. They're looking to learn whether or not you can conduct a successful trade-off between different options while displaying a broad understanding of the various options. In some of these questions, you might feel as though they're poking a hole in your understanding, but always be confident. Answer what you can, and don't be afraid to admit if you don't know something. This shows them your willingness to learn. The last thing they want is someone fabricating their understanding of a particular topic, because there's really no such thing as fake it till you make it in data science. You'll be working with extremely smart people that'll see straight through you. Finally, after the scenario-based questions, you'll be asked a couple of culture fit questions. So this will be things like, why do you want to work for this particular data science team or at this particular company? Your answers will be defined by how well you've done your research about the company and the people that work there. So for this step, I always find it useful to go through the company website, look through a couple of the LinkedIn profiles of the people that work there, and go through any Glassdoor reviews. All of these will give you a good sense as to the culture of the company and also give you a couple of things to talk about. And additionally, be genuinely curious about your interviewers. So have a look at their experience and prepare a couple of questions to ask them. And ideally, this should be questions that are specific about their experience. For example, it could be, what's the most rewarding project you've worked on so far at this company? Or what's your day-to-day look like? And also ask specific questions to your future roles. So what will your first 3 months look like if you get hired? Or what type of projects you'll be working on? And this will give you a rough understanding as to what you're getting into. Again, I'll leave a link below to all of the interesting resources that have helped me in my data science interview preparation. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next week.